Hi, I'm Caroline from Doodles and Digits. Clocks are all around you. Do you see a clock in the room you're in right now? What do you notice about it? Telling time is such an important skill to have, and that's what we're gonna learn about today. Let's get into it.
Doodly doodle, doodly doodle, doodly doodles and digits. Area, symmetry, fractions too, it's all here for you.
Why is it important to know how to tell time in the real world?
Telling time is an important skill that you're going to use every day. Whether you're trying to figure out what time school starts or class ends, what time a flight is or how long it's going to take to get there, or even just simple things like doctor's appointments and what time it's going to get dark, telling time is an essential skill to have.
Let's look at this clock right here. What do you notice? What do you wonder? What are the different parts of a clock?
When you look at a clock, you might notice a few things. You might notice these little lines around the clock. What do they represent? There are 60 seconds in a minute, and there are 60 minutes in an hour. These lines show the clock broken down into 60 portions. Here, take a look. These darker lines on the clock show us intervals of 5 so that it's easier to quickly tell what time it is. Now that we know what the lines represent, let's look at the hands. These are the hands of a clock. The shorter hand tells us the hour, and the longer hand tells us the minute.
All right, let's look at this clock right here. This clock is actually showing the time, 10:15. How do you think this clock shows 10:15? The smaller hand shows the hour of the time, and the larger hand is going to show the minutes. But here's the thing, when we're talking about the minutes, we're gonna actually be thinking of increments of 5. There are 60 minutes in an hour. So when this longer hand is actually pointing towards the 3, you can see that it's 15 minutes because all these little teeny tallies here represent 1 minute. It's a little confusing. Let's try it again. Let's look at this clock right here. What time is this clock showing?
The long hand is on the 2, so we can count that it is showing 10 minutes. And the short hand is on the 8, so our time is 8:10.
Wait a minute. Sometimes when I'm reading a clock, you might notice that the small hand is actually past the number that we're trying to say it is. For example, if it's 10:45, the small hand is past the 10. Why is that? Why is the hand sometimes past the number that we say the time is? That's a great question. So this is actually how a clock works. An analog clock, as it spins, it moves the smaller hand so that if it's closer to the next hour, so let's say 10:45, the smaller hand will look closer to the 11 than the 10. Now you might be asking yourself, wait a minute, this is just one type of clock. What about these other clocks or digital clocks? Today, we're just going to focus on what is called an analog clock.
What does AM or PM mean? You might notice that times have AM or PM next to them. This is because there are actually 24 hours in a day, or hours that it takes for the Earth to rotate around one time. Since there are only 12 hours on a clock, but 24 hours in a day, the AM and the PM show us if we are talking before midday or after midday. AM stands for antemeridian, which in Latin means before midday, and PM refers to afternoon or midday, postmeridian, which is Latin for after midday. For example, 8 a.m. is in the morning, while 8 p.m. is later in the evening.
All right, now that we've practiced telling time together some, let's see if you can solve a few of these on your own.
What time is the clock showing? As you can see, the long hand is at the 5, so if we count by intervals of 5, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, we are 25 minutes, and the small hand is at the 6, so this clock is showing 6:25. What time is the clock showing? This clock shows 11:50. The small hand is a little past the 11, and the large hand is at the 10. So if we count by fives, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, the large hand being at the 10 represents 50 minutes. What time is the clock showing? This clock is showing 1:32. The small hand is at the 1, and the long hand is 32 minutes past. We can count by fives, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and it's a little past the 6. Two little jumps past the 6 makes 32. Did you get it correct?
I hope you learned something really important about time today. Telling time is such an important skill, and it's a skill you're going to use the rest of your life. Try to see if there's a clock in your room right now. Can you tell the time? I hope this video is helpful. Bye!